Welcome back to the City Stay in True to Yourself podcast. Our goal is to facilitate the necessary discussion of how to stay true to yourself. Our vision is to promote and stimulate thought to restore culture and self-determination. We facilitate discussions to value the self and community through scholarships and creative dialogues. This is a movement that promotes and displays conscious uniqueness and addresses the methods of valuing self and community. We are all individuals, but our experiences and emotions are unique to yourself. To join the movement, follow us on Instagram at SITTY and check out the website to join the movement at www.staytrue2yourself.com. Yo, happy Black History Month to everybody around the world, and to all the listeners out there, much love, much peace, much cheers to all y'all. And here's just a little piece I want to start off the month with. It's called Reflecting. It's a Happy New Year. It's crazy how Black History Month is the second month of the year, I guess, in the Western culture, but we're not going to get into that. What I'm going to get into, though, is just my piece, what I got to share. And here's how it goes. And the piece is called Reflecting. I spend time looking at the mirror, flicking my eyes to the senses of my ears today, hearing how I seek. But yet only my vision is clear to me. I taste the wind as I suffer through my mist ocean of battles that I have to hold it. But yeah, I sniff some glory. I tell myself my mind is my greatest object. My hand is my greatest reach. My leg is my greatest step. My foot is my biggest stop. My grief will tell me I live a life of certificate. Is a social construct to show me that I am written in history. My breath, my taste, my smile, my hair. This is who I am. This is who you are. The dichotomy of the mind and human cut. So analogous. I question, why do we have heroism? I question to wonder, where is the ultimate glory? Barrage, always find the light of the end of the tunnel. But to myself, I don't see myself in the tunnel. I see myself as the light at the end of the tunnel because I channeled my own camp is my path. My eyes sprinkle visions. My eyes shut. Sprinkled obsession, controlled power. But I digress because I could not be who I am without your consciousness around. I say thank you. I commend you. I respect you. I give so much gratification and gratitude. But I can do sometimes. I just wipe my own tears and try to cleanse myself to be as pure and holy as possible. But sometimes with the veins, my ears hear, and the things my mouth say and my tongue, meticulous can sometimes lead me to trouble. But I am not my biggest enemy. I am my biggest friend, but I will also say, as my biggest friend, I am my biggest enemy. So I channel to pursue my dream, but I also challenge you as you hear this to understand your objectivity of the subject. Like I said, is there any hair or air? You are your own hero. You are you, old. I feel like that Batman. But sometimes I feel like that Robin. I could be Aquaman sometimes, but I want to be Iron Man. Who am I to judge? It's just the motion of my ocean that I'm going to allow to see more control of how I can just maintain staying in truth to myself. Thank you, and as always, pursue your dream and seize the day. Carpe diem, bitches. Woo!